안녕하세요, 제이름은 나미입니다. Hi, it's Nami. Today I'm going to do a really quick tutorial for how I do my bun with any kind of household object that is long and thin. I posted a video to my Snapchat and Instagram stories of the kids playing at the park, and I was just sitting on the bench, but it was very hot, so I wanted to put my hair up, and I put my hair in a bun with my car keys. I didn't really think much of it, but Green Turtle on Instagram asked for a tutorial, so I just figured, hey, that's such a great idea to do a tutorial on how I tie my bun with basically any kind of long object that you could use, any stationery, or I like to personally use chopsticks. You could even do this with a fork, basically anything that is long and skinny. Also, if you're wondering where I got my phone case, it literally plays actual games. There's 36 games in here that are like classic games. I'll have a link in the description if you're interested in this, because there are old games in here like Tetris, Pac-Man, and like the phone case actually plays it. I have a code for free shipping if you're interested. But let me just turn around and show you how I usually tie my bun. I like to do this kind of higher up on my head. You could honestly do this from any point of your head that you like. You could do it at the bottom, the middle, or the top. I usually tie my buns and my ponytails at the top just because I like it off my neck. And just like any other bun, I start to spin this hair. So when I turn my hair, I like to turn it and lay it flat to my head like this and kind of rotate and spin the hair and have it turn and tuck under itself. So right here, I'm running out of hair and I like to tuck it under this section right here, the top section. And what I do is I take my chopstick and I grab this section that's gonna lay on top of my end piece, and I'm going to stab this section in half so that my chopstick is now on the outside of my end piece. Then I'm gonna tuck the chopstick underneath the end piece so that now my end piece is pinned up against the rest of the bun. But then I'm gonna insert the chopstick through half of this other side so that it contains the end piece in between the bun and presses the end piece in between the bun and the chopstick. Having this inside and outside piece as almost like locks to the end piece being pushed in the middle, it allows the hair to stay in the bun with this chopstick. I'm gonna demonstrate again. So I'm just basically spinning around my hair and placing it under itself on this bun. And I'm gonna use this extra long chopstick. This chopstick is used for frying food. So right here, I'm gonna stab this section in half, but I'm gonna have my chopstick come out on the outside of the end piece. I'm gonna tuck my end piece into the bottom there, and then try to pull this last section to get it stuck. There we have a bun with a chopstick through it. And literally, the chopstick's the only thing that's holding up the hair. The longer the stick, the more preferred. I find that a regular chopstick is the perfect length, but you can also do this with a pen or any kind of stationery pencil as well. I like to take the sharp point of the pen just because it's easier to kind of get into the hair with it. I do think car keys is pushing it a bit. Like, I would say this is half the size of the minimum you would want. You'd probably want like 6 fingers worth, but my car keys are only 3 fingers worth. However, it does work if you are in a pinch. I will tell you though that it did fall out at the park. But I mean, it worked if you just want it temporary. And that is how I do my bun with basically any sharp, not sharp, but like skinny long object. This was kind of a random and short video, but I hope you found it helpful. And now you can basically put up your hair in any situation or circumstance as long as you have like a pen, fork, a chopstick, car keys. If you like this video, definitely make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't, go ahead and give it a thumbs down. If you'd like to see more, definitely make sure to subscribe and hit the bell notification to be notified right when new videos drop. That's usually the time that we do take to reply to your comments. I also post every day on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and Snapchat. So I'll check you out on these platforms if they are platforms that you use. That's it, and I will see you next time.